Students, in today's class we start the new topic from organic chemistry, that is amines. Okay students, so this is very important topic from organic chemistry. So in today's class we discuss about the some basic concepts and introduction part about the amines. So first of all you see what are the amines. Okay students, so you know the ammonia, so everybody knows the structure of ammonia. So ammonia is nothing but NH3. Okay, so this is what ammonia. So students, you know how amines will be prepared. So actually amines are nothing but the derivative, alkyl or aryl derivative of ammonia. So you know amines NH3. So in that NH3, if one or more hydrogen atom is replaced by alkyl or aryl group, there is a formation of amines. Very simple. Suppose you take an NH3 and from that NH3, if you remove the one hydrogen and if you substitute the one R, there is a RNH2 is nothing but amines. So instead of that R, you can add the aryl group, means benzene ring. That is a aromatic amines, is nothing but aniline. Just see here, see the definition of amines. So amines are alkyl or aryl derivatives. What I say, amines are the alkyl or aryl. Aryl means benzene ring. Aryl derivatives of ammonia, NH3. Okay, they are obtained by the replacement of one or more hydrogen atom of ammonia. Okay, so from ammonia, one and more hydrogen atom is replaced by what? Alkyl or aryl group. Alkyl group we can represent it by R and aryl group AR. Okay, means aromatic compounds. Okay students, so just check it. So this is NH3. So from this NH3, if you remove the one hydrogen, okay, minus one H, so what? And by removing the 1H, you can substitute one R. That is a RNH2. It is nothing but what? Amines. Very simple. Now clear students, how amine is found? So from, it is actually derivative of ammonia. So from ammonia, if you remove the one hydrogen and if you substitute the any alkyl or aryl groups, simply we will get what? Amines. Okay? So this is the definition of amines. Okay? So now we see the classification of amines. Just check it. So primary amines, RNH2, means from ammonia, from NH3, one hydrogen is replaced by one alkyl or aryl groups. Here just check it, RNH2, actually NH3 is there. Okay, so from this NH3, if you remove the one hydrogen and if you substitute the one R, we get what? Primary amine. You can see this is a 1-degree amine also. Okay, instead of this R group, if you take the any aromatic ring, just see here, I am taken here benzene ring containing the NH2 group. So from benzene, one hydrogen is replaced by that NH2 group. Okay, means from this ammonia, hydrogen is replaced by what? One benzene ring. We say it is aniline. Okay, this is aromatic amine. Now clear students, this is the primary amine. See the secondary amine. So in secondary amine what? So from this NH3, now two hydrogen is replaced by two alkyl groups. So in this NH3, three hydrogen are there. If you remove the two hydrogen and if you substitute with the two alkyl groups, means two hydrogen if you remove, then NH, and you can attach the two alkyl groups, we can say this is a secondary amines, or we can say it is a 2-degree amine also. Now clear? So in case of the aromatic ring also, instead of this R, if you take the benzene ring here and here, okay, that is a aromatic diamines. Now clear students, see the example here I have taken, CH3 NH CH3. So instead of this R, I have taken the methyl group. Instead of this R, I have taken here another methyl group. Okay, instead of methyl, you can take ethyl group also. Then you can see these are ethyl-methyl amines. Here, it is a two times, you can see this is dimethyl amine. In case of the primary also, I have taken CH3NH2, this is a methyl amine. Now, clear students, see the next tertiary amines. Tertiary amine, we can represent it by 3-degree. Okay, so what is a tertiary amine? From the ammonia, 3 hydrogen is replaced by 3 alkyl or aryl group. Very simple. So you know the structure of ammonia. So that from that NH3, all 3 hydrogen we can remove and we can substitute it to the 3R. We will get what? Tertiary amine. See the example here. Instead of this R, I have taken the CH3, CH3, CH3. Okay, here N is there and 3 methyl group is there. We can see it is a trimethyl amine. In case of the aromatic amine, you can take the 3 benzene ring like this. Okay, you can substitute the nitrogen and you can add the 3 benzene ring. Instead of that, I am written here AR means aromatic ring. Here also AR. Here also AR. Now, clear? Let's see, it is a benzene ring. So next is a quaternary amines, which is a 4-degree amines. Means one more alkyl group. Okay, only 3 hydrogen is there, but one more alkyl group is added to the nitrogen. So plus charge will come. It is a quaternary amines. Now, dear students, these are the classification of amines. I hope everybody understand the definition and as well as classification amines. Now we'll see the structure of amines. Okay, students, see now structure of amines. How the structure of amines? You know the amines are NH2. Okay, so this is amine. Okay, so this is a nitrogen which contains the 2 hydrogen and 1 alkyl groups. Okay, so like ammonia. Ammonia, you know the structure NH3. Ammonia is what? NH3. Like ammonia, nitrogen atom of amine is trivalent. Here, just see this nitrogen which contains the 2 hydrogen and 1 alkyl group. Means it is a trivalent and it carries a unshared pair of electron, because it have the unshared pair of electrons. So we can see it is a lone pair of electron also. Okay, so that these are the unshared pair of electrons. That unshared pair of electron does not take part in the any chemical reactions. Okay, so that does not form the bond also. So these are the unshared pair of electrons. And nitrogen orbital in amines are sp3 hybridized. You know the hybridization. So it undergoes sp3 hybridizations. Now, clear students? So what is the structure? It is a trivalent and it have the sp3 hybridization. Means 1s and 3p orbitals are involved. Okay. So already we discussed in the hybridization concept. Okay. So now just see the students. Now just see the geometry of the amines. Okay. So actually, geometry of amines, it is a pyramidal. It is a pyramidal in shape due to the presence of unshared pair of electrons. So already we discussed here. So this is a amine structure. This R and this nitrogen, this two R. It have some lone pair of electrons. So due to that, it have the shape is a pyramidal in shape. Okay. So due to the unshared pair of electrons. So just see the bond angle between this. Okay. So the bond angle between carbon, nitrogen and E. Here E is nothing but what? E is carbon or hydrogen. Okay, students. Just see here. So carbon and hydrogen, the bond angle, it is less than 109.5 degree. And in case of the trimethylamine, you know the structure of trimethylamine. So this is a trimethylamine, CH3 and CH3, CH3. So it is bond angle how much? Carbon and carbon is much. This bond angle is 108 degree. Now clear? So this is a bond angle between this trimethyl amine. So this is a geometry of amines. Now clear students? So in structure of amine, already we discussed about their shape. It is a trivalent in shape. Okay, then it is a pyramidal. Then it have the bond angle hybridization how much? It is a sp3 hybridizations and bond angle 108 degree in case of the trimethyl amines. Okay students, I hope everybody understand this basic concept. So next class we'll discuss about the nomenclature of amines. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video.